Hi family, it's Marin here and I have a really special guest. First of all, I want to thank you for being here. This is Dr. Jesse Broderson of Malama Chiropractic here on the Big Island of Hawaii. And I'm just so thankful for you being here because we've had a lot of people talking about the floor sleeping videos.
Right, yeah.
And we wanted to answer some of your questions, but with a medical professional, so it's not just my word, but you know, we get some ideas on floor sleeping. Is it good? Is it bad? What you can do about it? And if it's something that's good for you?
Sure. Well, thanks for having me, Marin.
Absolutely.
Yeah, great to meet all you guys. Fun to be here with you today. And yeah, that was a fun question when you asked me that. It was interesting that you had mentioned that when you started talking about your sleeping habits, that your audience really was like, "Wow, what is that? Why do you do that?" And so I think it's a great question, and I'm happy to be here with you guys and talk about it.
We appreciate it
for sure. Yeah.
So before we get started, one of the things that I want to recap you guys on is why we floor slept in the first place. I really didn't even think about it because it was something organic that took place. You guys know we travel and we move a lot, and moving a bed and a mattress was like a really big deal. And it was adding decreasing value in our lives.
Sure.
You know? So we kind of just moved down to like a mattress topper. And we really ended up becoming spoiled over the idea of folding it and being able to put it away and have all this extra space in our house. And then when we went back to a traditional mattress, it didn't feel good.
Right.
So we kept floor sleeping, you know? And so if those of you guys who are out there that are interested in some of those benefits of floor sleeping, you know, I really wanted to just cap on what you would say the ideal sleeping situation is per individual. And of course, everybody's different.
So. Yeah, that's of course, you know, the disclaimer that I'll put on this is that, this is going to be an individual case basis, and you want to be working with a healthcare professional, especially if this ends up causing pain in some sort of a way. So, but for you guys, obviously, your body adapted to it. You got used to it. That's a common question that I get in my chiropractic office is, you know, what's the best mattress? What's the best pillow? What should I be sleeping on? And my answer has always been, and this is just from my own personal opinion or experience, is that you want to sleep on a firm surface, you know, because you definitely want to avoid soft surfaces that end up sagging, and especially if you're on a mattress that is worn down and one side is dipping in or the other, or maybe both of you, or if you're a couple and both of you are rolling together into the middle, you know how that is. And so I've always been a fan of a firm surface with some sort of a either a memory foam topper or something like that. I'm not a big fan of the plush super sleeper, you know, those type of things, because the feathers just dip in too much. Okay. And so that's always been my general rule of thumb, either on your back or your side, avoid stomach sleeping, pillow underneath your knees, and a neck support pillow. So I wanted to just show you guys an example of the ideal sleeping or ideal resting position, which is going to be on your back. That's what we're going to do for Marin. Go ahead and lay on your back here, Marin. And yeah, go ahead. You can take your shoes off. And I've got a neck roll here. Go ahead and pull your hair back. Tuck that in so that your head's arching over it. And then here is a knee cushion. Okay, go ahead and drop that up. Okay, so, you know, the idea behind sleep, of course, is this is our time to rest, rejuvenate, and repair. Okay, so in order to do that, you need to get your body in a neutral position, even structurally, and so that your body is not under stress, meaning like loading stress while you're at rest. And so these beds right here are essentially just about 2 inches of cushion, and then it must be plywood underneath there. And so you can feel that. It's a firm surface. It's not sagging. Again, most of all of our body weights are going to be most of our body weight is going to be from your shoulders pretty much just to about your hips. And so if you're on a soft surface, that's going to sag in and you'll create the hammock effect where your spine's dipping in, the head is elevated, the legs are elevated. And if you can imagine it, the bottom of that spine is going to be the apex. And so those spinal joints are going to be under a certain amount of load, AKA not at ease, right? And so when I'm talking about trying to get the body in a neutral position in order to allow for the best rest, the best repair, the best rejuvenation, then this is it right here, sleeping on your back, firm surface. We've got a neck roll underneath you, or you could just use, you know, a regular pillow. I use one of those contour memory foam pillows. And then a knee cushion, you know, and what this does is this helps take a little bit of the load off the lumbar spine, off the low back. And so this would be the most neutral sleeping position possible. How does that feel, Marin?
Amazing,
right?
And you guys made your own bed, didn't you?
Yeah.
I'm like skipping ahead here.
But yeah, no, that's fine. Yeah, so going with that firm surface, and we actually, my wife, she used to work for a chiropractor who did this about 20 years ago, and she remembers this guy, this chiropractor, telling her that he had made his own bed, and it basically what he did was he built a platform, just a wooden platform, you know, used some 2x4s, put some plywood down, put it on cinder blocks, and then what he did was he went to a upholstery store, and he ordered a piece of upholstery foam, and upholstery foam comes in different densities, and so I think he got like a five inch thick, you know, queen or king or whatever he ordered at the time, and a dense upholstery foam, and then he put a memory foam pad on top of that.
So no box spring.
No box spring, no nothing. Okay. And then of course, I think so that's what we did. We ended up ordering a piece of upholstery foam.
Gotcha.
To the size that we wanted. We got a king, and then we put a dense or a piece of memory foam topper on top, and that was actually just about 2 inches. And then we put a mattress foam, you know, or a mattress pad over it, and that helped with the heat. And that's it. And the crazy thing is we've had that bed now for over 14 years.
Oh, wow.
And
it's a long time for
that's
bed.
A long time. Yeah. You know, we take it off and we clean it every now and then, air, you know, and things like that, but we've never had to rotate it. You know, it doesn't give in on one side or the other. And so that's what we did. And it's still the best bed I've ever been on. And my parents got the Tempur-Pedic. They've got the Sleep Number. They've been going bed crazy, you know, over the last decade and stuff. And I go and I try their bed out, and I'm like, still doesn't beat my bed.
Yeah.
So at any rate, a firm surface with a memory foam pad.
That's like the super lush way of doing
it. Yeah, totally.
So, I mean, at the end of the day, what can we tell them? Is floor sleeping good or bad?
You know, I think that, again, if it provides for a firm surface, this is one thing, maybe the disclaimer for me and my understanding of the human frame and how it, you know, how loading and gravity and the weight of ourselves affects the human body, is that if you're on a soft surface and the majority of your body is from here to your waist, and so if it's on a soft surface and all of that's going to dip in, you get the hammock effect where your legs are elevated, your head is pushed forward, and that's going to stress the joints of the spine. When we're just talking about posture decay or abnormal posture, of course there's neutral normal posture where the head is loading through the body, upper body loading through the hips. And then what starts to happen is you guys have all seen this, where it's this steady progression where gravity just is literally loading down on the person and they literally can't stand up straight. And so, you know, when we're talking about floor sleeping, you definitely want to make sure, you know, it would probably not be appropriate, you know, for these different levels of posture and health like that. So, but of course the idea is that floor sleeping will allow you to maintain that vertical alignment. And then, so I think I like what you guys were talking about, how you transition to a foam pad. You know, I would say that'd be maybe a good transition if you're on a mattress to then get onto maybe a futon or a foam pad. If you want to eventually work your way to more of like a yoga pad, and your body can handle it. I think you were saying you use pillows to kind of help prop up the knees,
yeah,
or in between the knees. And really, if your body can handle it, you got the flexibility in your spine to handle it, then I think it's totally fine.
And one of the things that I appreciated that you mentioned was the weight and how the load should be distributed evenly, mm-hmm, throughout the body. So if you guys are feeling extremely weight like in your shoulders or, mm-hmm, your hips or your shoulder blades, then you want to put something to help distribute that a little bit more.
Correct.
So that's a lot of people ask, what's the point of having all the pillows if you want to floor sleep anyways? And it's because you want to be able to make sure that you can still support yourself.
Yeah.
And it's easy to just fold up and not have the mattress in the way. You know, you still get the same benefits. And
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's, you know, there's been a few times that I've suggested that people sleep on the floor prior to this conversation.
Okay.
And it's always been if they travel a lot and if they end up in a hotel room where the bed is just horrible, I'm like, well, sleep on the floor. Take the comforter, fold it up in a full couple folds, set it on the floor, sleep on a firm surface. You'd likely be able to wake up, stretch out the stiffness of the firm surface as opposed to being in some sort of sunken position.
And you guys
position.
Know that we do that.
Absolutely.
Like, you would sleep on the hotel floor, but
absolutely.
Yeah, we definitely, because it's tough for us to get into a bed.
Right.
So now reviewing my notes here.
Yeah.
We had some people say they're overweight or they feel a lot of pain in floor sleeping
right.
or they're side sleepers.
Right.
What would you suggest to those people?
Yeah, maybe then that transition, maybe put a pad underneath you. Sometimes you know those futons, the three-piece folding futon, and usually those are about 3 inches thick. I would say transition to that. And then the pillow situation.
Yeah.
You know, prop it underneath your knees and between your knees, maybe get one of those longer body pillows so that if if you're tossing and turning, you're going to side sleep, you can have the pillow in between your knees with a little bit of the weight on the pillow. And the whole idea is side sleeping, especially if you have some mass on you, you know, it's really going to collapse or compress the shoulder blade. And you got to watch out for that. And so again, if it's causing you pain, I'd work with a healthcare professional, a chiropractor, physical therapist, or your medical doctor and work something
out. And it might not be for you. You know, like floor sleeping doesn't have to be for everybody. And I want to remind everybody that floor sleeping doesn't necessarily mean just the blanket on the floor.
Right.
You know, when we were on a hardwood floor, we had like a 3-inch memory foam, and that was really good. There was no way I could do it on the hardwood floor. And if you want to avoid having a mattress and you want to have a more simplified bed setup, like the foldable mattresses, I mean, I had one that was like 6 inches that folded three ways.
Right.
So it's just removing like the bed frame, you know? So
absolutely.
Customize it for yourself, you know? And again, work with somebody who knows what they're talking about that can really make sure that you're doing good things for your spinal health and your body alignment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like that the way that you guys are sleeping, all of a sudden it allows for the room to get big. If you want it to be big, just fold that up and then it's a big room, I'm sure, to stretch and do yoga and do all that other
Absolutely.
Stuff. So, I it's fun. I'm glad you guys are taking charge of that and trying it out. And if it works for you, that's fun.
Yep. And he is actually my chiropractor. So I'm not beating my spine up, am I?
No. I think you're fine. As long as you're, you know, just paying attention to your body, you know, listen to any warning signs. And, you know, most likely it'll be a good idea to be adjusted. If you are planning on sleeping on the floor, it's simply a good idea to get adjusted anyways. But for flexibility and mobility in the spine, that should help.
Well, I really want to thank you for being here with us and for sharing all those tips. I hope you guys got some good value. If you have any questions for Dr. Jesse, stick them in the comments below. I'm also going to put Malama Chiropractic link in the description below in case you're on the Big Island. Come check it out. He's really great, and I'm really picky when it comes to chiropractics, so I was really happy to have found Malama Chiropractic and to have Dr. Jesse help me with my spine and just make sure everything is healthy and good. So check that out. And then, do you have any social media on which you can respond back if people?
Yeah, we're on Instagram at Malama Chiropractic. We have a Facebook account, and you can reach us, you know, go to our website, and or you can email me directly at drbroderson@gmail.com.
Okay, awesome. Yeah. And so we want to thank you so much for being
Absolutely.
Here. I really appreciate it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like it, give us a thumbs up and make sure you comment below. If you have subscribed, thank you for joining the family. Welcome. We will see you guys in the next video.
All right.
All
have a good one.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Jesse.
Yeah, for sure.
All right.
All right.
Bye.